The Red Sea crisis continues to hurt the shipping and logistics industries. Oman's Salalah port reports a 16% decline in container volumes in the first half of the year as ships reroute around the southern tip of Africa to avoid Houthi attacks in the Red Sea. The port, which is Oman's closest to the border with Yemen, handled just around 1.7 million shipping containers in the first half. That's below the nearly 2 million it handled a year earlier. Salalah port expects container volumes to continue to fall for at least the rest of the year if the crisis remains unresolved. On Thursday, Dubai-owned ports and logistics company DP World reported a 59% drop in first-half profit, hurt by shipping disruptions. The Philippine Land Transport Regulator begins issuing warnings to motorists passing through expressways without a license plate. This is as the agency prepares for a phased implementation of the barrier-less tollway system. Andrea Taguines reports.
In just 1 hour, the Land Transportation Office, or LTO, already had to issue warnings to over 100 motorists passing through the Skyway Del Monte Toll Plaza in Quezon City. That's because their vehicle either had no license plate or they were still using a temporary or improvised plate. One motorist was even slapped with a ticket for supposedly trying to get away with not following the coding scheme.
Sa plaka, may sign na po na pinagbaklasan po ng tornilyo. Ibig sabihin po, nakabit na po, tinanggalan po ulit. Siguro po, for dial coding.
Ilagay na po nila yung mga plaka nila. No? Wala na akong kulang na plaka. Plaka po, we have already inventory, no? Lahat ng plaka nasa dealer po.
This is part of the agency's information drive before the planned implementation of the barrier-less toll road system before the end of 2024. The government aims to speed up the flow of traffic in expressways by directing toll operators to remove the barriers in toll plazas or the actual toll gates.
Ang plaka po ay nagiging identification din ng sasakyan, no? So if we cannot identify the vehicle at the barrier-less po na yan, eh paano natin papatupad yung barrier-less? Eh paano kung di magbayad? Diba? Paano kung magpasaway sa loob ng expressway?
Many motorists are in favor of the barrier-free system.
Yung mga tolls din, doon din naman nagbabottleneck minsan yung traffic. And then yun, I think makakatulong din talaga.
Mainam nga po sana kung ASAP eh, di ba? Yung mga long weekend yan, especially. Nako po eh, Diyos ko, oras ang binibilang sa toll gate para makalabas.
According to the LTO, it is currently conducting coordination meetings with toll operators and the Toll Regulatory Board, or TRB, to achieve its target of implementing the barrier-free toll road system ahead of the Christmas travel rush. But Mendoza said this will first be done by way of a pilot run.
Infrastructure din eh. Diba, gagawin nila yung mga, yung mga reader machines. Identify din natin with the expressways, no? Kung saan tayo ready. Ready ba tayo sa lahat ng entrance and exits ng expressway? Yun, soft launch would include a territorial area where we can launch it.
In a statement, the TRB also stressed the importance of testing out the system first to ensure its accuracy and efficiency and so as not to inconvenience motorists. The Metro Pacific Tollways Corporation, which runs several expressways such as NLEX and SCTEX, earlier said, apart from coming up with a technology, they also have to wait for the regulations and corresponding penalties against motorists who don't have an RFID system installed or don't have enough load. The LTO, meanwhile, said Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista already signed this month the department order which lays down the regulatory framework for the program, but they are still waiting for it to be published. Meanwhile, an official of San Miguel Corporation, which operates the Skyway and SLEX, also expressed the company's readiness to comply with the removal of toll barriers within the year. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
China's gig workers are finding permanent employment in a place you would never expect. Thousands of workers have secured jobs at what China calls love stations. The rest stops and cooling centers, originally designed for sanitation workers, have become a place for people to seek employment. The station provides cheap meals and charging facilities, as well as postings for various odd jobs. Over 54,000 people have found jobs thanks to a love station in southwest China's Yushan district.